Hey guys, today I wanted to share with you my favorite skincare for 2021. So we are wrapping up the year. It's almost 2022, and I thought I would look back and see all of the skincare that I have been loving for 2021. So instead of doing my monthly favorites, I did a yearly roundup of all of the favorite skincare that I've been using. I have tried so many new products for this year just because I was looking for those great anti-aging products. I have found that a few of my favorites always revert back to my holy grails, but there are some new ones that I've tried this year that I really do like. So today I wanted to share with you my top 10 skincare products for 2021. So I wanted to go ahead and start off with cleansers. And so there are two cleansers that I want to share with you today. One is a holy grail that's been a favorite forever, but it has also been a favorite this year as well. And then I tried a newer product this year that's new to me, and I really liked it too. So I wanted to show you my old favorite that is still a favorite for me, and then a new favorite that I have for 2021. So first off, let's start with this one from Aveeno. So this one is the Calm Plus Restore, and it's for sensitive skin. I wouldn't say that I have sensitive skin. I have normal to dry skin. My skin's not real sensitive to fragrances, but I don't like to have products that have fragrances in it just because I feel like it is a little bit drying on my skin. I just don't like to smell it. So this one is a really good one, like I said, for sensitive skin, but I have normal to dry skin and I love it. It's in a pump dispenser, and this is another one that I repurchased. I had finished one, so this is a newer one that I've repurchased. I've only been using this for probably about the last week and a half, but I use it daily at night, and it's fragrance free, so I really like that because I don't like skincare that has fragrances in it. I mean, I will use some, but I don't really prefer a fragrance. I really like for them to be fragrance free, and this one is. It says it gently cleanses and hydrates to preserve the skin's moisture barrier. So I really liked this because, like I say, I have dry skin, especially in the wintertime. I have really dry skin. So this is really good about hydrating the skin. It feels really nice, and it just really cleans all of your makeup off. I do have to use a specific makeup cleanser that I will use for my eyes for waterproof because this doesn't really get that off very well. But this is really great, and I did just start using this past year, so I found that I really do like this one. So this one's a great one from Aveeno, drugstore price, really affordable, and it lasts forever. The next cleanser I'm gonna show you, maybe no surprise if you've seen some of my older videos, because this has been a holy grail for me for years. I have been using this for probably about 5 years now, maybe even 6 years. I've been using it for as long as I can remember. I always revert back to this because I love it so much, but I always do like to try the new cleansers to see if there's gonna be something that's gonna replace this. I really do like that Aveeno one that I've showed you. That's actually what I'm using right now. But this one has been a holy grail for me forever. I love it. It's from CeraVe. Almost everything in their product line is so good. This is the Hydrating Facial Cleanser, and it says it's for normal to dry skin, which is that exactly what I have, so it's not drying. It's really nourishing. It has ceramides and hyaluronic acid in it. It gives you that plumping effect, so you don't have that loss of elasticity. Love it. It's, again, in a pump container. Both of these are so good. I love them, and they're both drugstore prices, so they are super affordable. They're both fragrance-free, and they're both great for normal to dry skin. Next up, I wanted to show you this cleansing oil that I really like. So when I was talking about the Aveeno and even the CeraVe cleansers, they don't get a lot of that stubborn eye makeup, that waterproof makeup off, so I will go in first before I use my cleanser with the cleansing oil to try to get that and loosen that up on my eyes. And so I will use this from Biossance. It's good for just not just the eye area, but using it all over your entire face. Biossance has great products. I love them. Almost all of their products have squalane in them, so that's a really good base to start all of these skincare products off with. This one is an antioxidant cleansing oil. This is in a small trial size. Biossance, if you go to their website, it's really great about having trial sizes, mini sizes that you can purchase in case you are wanting to try out some of their products, or if you want to use them for travel. That's why I like to get the mini size, because I will use these all the time with traveling. They come in glass containers. This one has a pump dispenser on this one, but this is really great. It lasts a long time. Even for this to be a mini, it does last quite a while. And I will just massage this on to kind of loosen up all of that waterproof makeup, that hard to take off makeup, before I will put my cleanser on. Biossance is a little bit on the pricier side, but they do have really great ingredients in their products, and I just really love them. I have a lot of their product line. Most of their products I've tried or I currently use. There's just one or two products that I don't care for from their line, but everything else is really, really good, and you're gonna see a couple more products from Biossance in this skincare countdown. So I think this is so great. I love this cleansing oil to put on before my cleanser to just get all of that hard to take off makeup off. Next up, I wanna share with you a scrub that I've really been loving this year, and it's a newer one that I tried. I don't like really harsh scrubs. They can make your skin feel smooth afterwards, but they can do those micro tears, and I don't like that. So this is from Aveeno. It's the Positively Radiant line, and it's the Skin Brightening Daily Scrub. It has a soy extract in it, and it's supposed to make your skin brighter and more even toned. And it says that you can use it for everyday use, and it's even good for sensitive skin. I don't use this daily. I will only use this about once, maybe twice a week at night. When I'm cleansing, I will use this. If I'm using another product that has some kind of exfoliant in it, then I will not use this with it because I don't want to double exfoliate. So I will use this probably usually just once a week. And I do really love this. It makes my skin feel more toned. It kind of almost eliminates the pores, the larger pores. It makes them appear smaller right here in the area that I have to worry about the enlarged pores. And also, it's just mild enough. It's not abrasive. And I just love the softness that it gives my skin. After I use this, my skin feels so soft. So this one from Aveeno, the Skin Brightening Daily Scrub, is a really good one that I've really been loving for this entire year. It's a new one that I tried and it's just been really great. And it's been a go-to for me to use at least once a week. Next up, I want to share with you two masks that I love to use. So one of them I will use in the morning time. If I have enough time in the morning to use a mask, I love this one because it really makes your skin look radiant. So I will put this on, then I'll put the e.l.f. Luminous Putty Primer on, and then I'll put one of my Radiant Luminous Foundations on, and my skin just looks so healthy, so glowy, and I just love the way it looks. This mask is a great one. I don't use this at night just because it does give that radiant look to it. So I like to use this in the morning time. So it's from Honest Beauty and it's the Prime and Perfect mask. Now this comes in newer packaging. I did see when I went to go repurchase it that it does have new packaging. So this is the older packaging that this comes in. So if you do want to try this, it does come in a different packaging than what I'm showing you right now. But I love this mask. It's perfect for in the morning. So I will put this on and leave this on for like 5 or 6 minutes. I think you can leave it on for up to 10 minutes, but I will put it on for like 5 or 6 minutes and then wash it off. And it's a really bright pink color when you put it in. If you can see this right here, this is the color that it looks like on your skin when you put it on. But then when you rinse that off, it just feels so good. It has a healthy glow to it. And I just love it. It's a great foundation to start with. Before you even apply your makeup, it just makes your skin look so good. So this is a really good one and it lasts quite a while. I will use this, like I say, in the morning time. If I have time, I will try to use this once or twice a week. Most often it's just once a week, but I will try to use it twice a week. But I think you can use this daily if you wanted to. It's not gonna do anything to make your skin sensitive or anything, but I just really love this one. This one is a great mask. And then the other mask that I wanna share with you is a mask that I like to use at night when I'm doing a full pampering of my skin. And I wanna use this mask. It's from Origins. It's the Retexturing Mask with Rose Clay. Again, this is in a trial size. I do have a larger size of this. I just couldn't find it at the moment, but I do like to travel with this. This is the one that I will take with me when I travel, put it in my toiletry bag because it is in a trial size. It's in the 1 ounce, but these do come in, I think, a 2.7 ounce for your regular sizes. This is great because it has a little bit of fine beads, so they're like exfoliating beads. I just love the way that this makes my skin. Now, again, if I'm going to use this, I will not use that Aveeno Daily Scrub that I told you about, and I don't try to use any of my exfoliants that are in my serums as well if I'm going to use this because I don't want to over exfoliate my skin. This one is a great one. Between this one and the Origins Charcoal, these are my favorite masks to use at night. Next up, I want to share with you an eye cream that I absolutely love. I know there's controversy on whether you even need to get a specific eye cream or not. And I can tell you that I have been using eye cream since I was 19 years old. I'm 42 right now and I don't have any crow's feet. So I believe that between using some great eye creams, wearing my sunglasses all the time, rain or shine, so I'm not squinting at all, I don't have any crow's feet. I haven't had any kind of chemical alterations or anything like that to get rid of any crow's feet. I really don't have any at the age of 42, and I feel like it's because of the way I have taken care of my skin throughout the years, starting at a really early age. I know some people don't believe that you have to start with your anti-aging that early, but I did, and I really like the benefits from some of the eye creams. Now, I've used many different eye creams throughout the years, and this is the one that I've been using mostly for this year. I have been repurchasing this one because I found that this one is one of my favorite ones that I've used in quite a while. So this is the one that I'm sticking with right now. It's from Biossance. So like I said, you were gonna see a couple more products from Biossance. It's the Squalane Marine Algae Eye Cream. This again is in a mini size because this is what I travel with all the time. I do have it in a full size, and I actually will take it from my full size and replenish the mini size. And I just take it like a little spatula, a little small makeup spatula, and I will dip it back in here to fill this completely full for when I'm traveling, because this is my go-to eye cream. A lot of times, even during the day, I will put this in a handbag because I like to just put this on, even over my makeup. I will put this on just because I like to apply this. I know you don't have to apply this more than once a day. Sometimes people will apply in the AM and then in the PM as well. I will sometimes apply midday just because I love to have eye creams on. I just don't want those fine lines and to have to worry about crow's feet. So I love this. It's really good. It says that it firms and smooths your under eye area. I love this. This is one that I've been using for most of the year. And like I said, I really think that this makes a difference in your under eyes. Not so much of the brightening effect. I did use a Tarte one that gave a little bit more of a brightening effect, because when I don't have concealer on, it looks like I have black eyes. My under eyes are so dark that this does not really help with the dark circles. But I do think that it really helps with the firming of the under eyes. So this Marine Algae Eye Cream from Biossance has just been a go-to, and I just love the way that it hydrates and makes the under eyes feel, and just the way it feels like it makes them look and appear more firm. I have tried many different serums this year. I've tried about 3 or 4 from CeraVe. Also tried some other serums from some other higher-end companies. But the one that I found that I like the most right now, that I've been using, and I really like the appearance that it gives my skin, is from Biossance again, and it's the Squalane and Lactic Acid Resurfacing Night Serum. So I will put this on at night after I've cleansed my face and before I moisturize it. And then I will actually put 100% Squalane to just seal all of that in, to just really make it moisturizing, especially if I'm using a chemical exfoliant, then I definitely want to add that moisture in. And in the wintertime, my skin gets really, really dry, so I just want to just seal all of that stuff in. This makes my skin feel really good, and I feel like it feels a little bit plumper, and it looks more radiant. It just feels and looks better than when I don't use this. You can use this daily. I only use this about twice a week just because I will put the moisturizer over top of that, but I don't feel like it leaves my skin too greasy if I put this on with a moisturizer over top of it. You don't have to use this with a moisturizer, but I choose to, especially in the wintertime when my skin's really dry. But I really love this. I love the appearance that it gives my skin after I put it on. It's not harsh. And the thing with Biossance is they do, all of their products have a little bit of a scent to them. They're not fragrance free, but they have a slight scent to them, but they're not overwhelming and overpowering. But I do really like this. I think it's a great serum to use before your moisturizer. Next up, I wanna share some moisturizers with you. There has been one holy grail moisturizer that I just always go back to, and it's gonna be in this favorites video as well. But I wanted to show you a new one that I tried probably a year and a half ago, and I've really been coming back to it a lot this year as well. It is also from Honest Beauty, so I know I had a few items in here from Honest Beauty. It is the Hydrogel Cream with 2 types of hyaluronic acid. So again, I love those products that have the hyaluronic acid because it just really plumps up that skin, and it just really makes your skin look really good. So this is in a gel formula. This is good for even oily skin types. I have normal to dry skin, so it doesn't really make your skin feel greasy. Love is from Honest Beauty, fragrance free. It comes in this large size jar. It's 1.7 ounces and it lasts a long time. So this is a really good moisturizer. I will put this on at night, and I will also put this on in the morning time as well. So I do use this one twice a day. I think it's really good, non-greasy. Just plumps up the skin and makes it feel really, really hydrated. And then the other moisturizer that I'm gonna share with you is gonna be no surprise if you see any of my older videos. It's from CeraVe. It's the PM Facial Moisturizing Lotion. I used to actually get this when I subscribed to Amazon on Amazon Mom. I used to get this as a subscribe and save. So I would get this every, I think I would put it to get every 2 months because I did not wanna run out of this. This was a holy grail for me. It still is one that I always go to. It has a little pump dispenser on it. I love to use this all the time, but I do really like that Honest Beauty one, but I will only use this one in the PM. They do have an AM version, which has a sunscreen in it. I don't like it as well as I like this one because it doesn't feel as creamy to me. It feels a little bit more drying. The AM does over the PM. So I love this, really great. This has been a go-to for me for years, but it's still a favorite for 2021 because I still use it in 2021. And I've also been using that Honest Beauty one. Those are the ones that I use mostly for this past year. Okay guys, that's gonna be it for this video on best skincare for 2021. I rounded out my top 10. Most of these were some new ones that I had tried this year, not necessarily new releases, but new to me, and then two of my holy grails that are still my favorites. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. I would also love to have you consider hitting that subscribe button. I do weekly videos on fashion, beauty, and lifestyle. I'd love to see you in my next video. Until then, I hope you have a wonderful day.